This is my trip on the Great Central Railway Trans-County section. The train went from Ruddington Fields, turned around and called it Rushcliffe Halt, and then didn't stop at East Leek and went straight to just next to the brush works. It then changed direction and went back up, calling it Rushcliffe Halt again, before changing direction again and going back into Ruddington Fields. This is Ruddington Park Depot on the Great Central Railway, the section between Loughborough Central and Nottingham Victoria. There you have the depot, and over there is the station that's just used by the trains. It's a station used by the trains going down towards Loughborough. But they don't go all the way because it's not, haven't finished rebuilding it yet. They've still got a bridge. Oh, and so this is Ruddington Park Depot. There's numbers 8274, and under that 20D. These appear to be. This is a train. This train is marked as LMS. Well, the locomotive's LMS, and the carriages are in the LMS livery. LMS is now owned by Virgin these days. LMS is now owned by Virgin. And basically a three carriage train. I'm pretty sure I'm going to be going on that train later. I don't know what stations it stops at. Basically, there you have the depot. I'm going to go into the depot. I wish there was a path to the down to the platform. Annoyingly, I can't go through here because it is locked. Looks like it would be quite safe to walk down. There's quite a wide section. I would have to be careful though. This playground used to be a lot larger and it was really nice, but now they've all rebuilt it and it's not very good anymore. They've removed a lot of the old equipment. This is a Mark 1 sort of, I'm not sure if this is British Rail Mark 1, although I think they were all referred to as Mark 1s. It does have this, have a BR Bechler Watt window. It probably is a Mark 1. Mark 1, I think that all of these older style carriages were all referred to as Mark 1s around the time when the Mark 2 was brought out, no matter their age. And this is in the, what I think is the LMS livery. This is a first class compartment. I don't really know how it's going to work out with the other line, which has second and first class compartments and second and first class open type carriages. In the first class they seem to have the alarm chains on both sides.
Is there toilets?
This is an open carriage. Usually compartment carriages were first class, open carriages were second class, but sometimes it's not an absolute rule. And the alarm chain in here is only on one side. It's because it's all just one chain that runs along the entire length. And this is the light switch. And I I don't know what those light switches do. I don't know what all the light switches do. This door does not work. The window still works though. This is sort of like a southern region disabled accessible toilet space. Except facing in the opposite direction. I'm pretty sure this is the toilet, but I don't. But the door handle has come off the toilet, so you need a door handle. I don't know what's happened to the door. I think that's probably a toilet, but for some reason the door handle's missing. I don't know what happened. I don't know why you find that on the same train different carriages have different upholstery. And this carriage has different window shapes to the other two.
Nice pictures!
I think it's probably newer because there's no chain-based alarm. And I don't know where the alarm is. I think it's probably a newer carriage because it's not got a chain alarm. It's got a different alarm type. That's 8247, which is the locomotive on this train. 8274. And that is class 125.
So you got one each side.
I think I saw a class 125 once. It was running a not in service train. The locomotive still hasn't gone to the other end. This is Ruddington Park Depot. Well, they've now just changed the points for the locomotive to run around, and I'm not sure when it will. This train's scheduled to go at 3 o'clock. It's only on the heritage railways that don't run every day that you find such erratic timings. And it's 3:03, so we're a bit late. Well, not erratic. Precise. It's probably the opposite. The points have now been changed for the locomotive to run around. I just heard them changing. The locomotive hasn't run around, but I don't know how the locomotive's going to fit through there. No, we have to step in reverse very slowly. Something. I think what's happened is the signal stuck on red, and so now they've just given us permission to pass it at red because it was stuck on red. So now Ruddington Park Depot. The only other times I've seen class 125 was actually on not. There was a really dilapidated one, all rusty, on a not in service run. I don't know where it was. And now we're going under this bridge on the section of line that has a very low speed limit. And there's the playground that used to be a lot nicer and bigger. Is the signal that was broken. It was stuck on red. We're actually being pushed by the locomotive at the moment because we're actually technically going in the wrong direction. And down there, that end of, that doesn't end, down there after about a mile or so, there's a tram track. I'd rather like if they extended it to an interchange with the trams and then run the service every hour or so. I saw a Chinese shipping container. The most surprising thing to find around here would not be something all the way from China, but anything that has no rust on it. That there is where the up track was. It's been removed. This is the main noise the train makes as it goes along. The main section of the line is all really squeaky and rattly. And think that this was originally a high-speed line. I would blame beaching for our high rail fares. Because without the beaching acts, the beaching acts closed half the lines and it led to really no competition. If these lines had remained open, and then after privatisation they'd have competed with each other. Because with how it is now, there's no competition. The biggest forklift track I've ever seen, and this is the whitest road surface I've ever seen. I know the camera's adjusting for the auto exposure, but it's really white. This is a very poor excuse for a station. And I guess we've got breeze blocks, not very good quality. It's a rather poor excuse for a station. But then I guess it is a sort of industrial halt. How are people supposed to get in and out of this station if they want to get on and off? I mean, I guess there are those stairs there. We go to a factory. And there is access on the other side. I guess there's a barrow crossing over there, then there's that ramp up there to the road. Now we're going over something major, possibly the Trent. There's a viaduct here. And over there is Brush. Somewhere down in that direction. We're going south. Then we stopped to change direction next to the Brush Works. This is a huge factory where they modernise trains. They were pulling away from Loughborough, past Brushes. How big Brushes was. I never knew how big the Brush site was. Right now. number 318. So go over. Maybe it's the Trent or maybe it's not the Trent. There you can see the church tower of Lufford Church. That green dome tower is the Carillion, and there's also the student accommodation towers. All of the student accommodation has rather 80s sounding names. There's towers, which is a really cool one. There's gables. Most of them are a bit ugly. Loughborough. I hope I don't offend anyone. The line was built over 100 years ago, around 1920. It was going to be a high-speed railway. Broken toilet suite. It's broken toilet. And there's this trolley thing with a bottle of Mr. Muscle on it. That's an infrastructure building. I don't know what it might be, but it's definitely an infrastructure building. Here we're just about to go into the tunnel. And this train's lights are turned off, and it doesn't have those fancy lights that go on automatically when they go through a tunnel. So it goes really dark in here when it's in a tunnel. It's having just a short tunnel, and yet I can't see a thing. It's so dark in the tunnel here. And there aren't those fancy lights that come on automatically. Also, it's quite dark because we're in a cutting. In between luggage racks, which still work, are some lights here, which are manual lights, and they are broken. They don't have a light bulb. It looks like they would have taken either two incandescents or maybe an arc, but probably not an arc, because this carriage, I think, was built around 40s, 50s, so I don't think it would have taken an arc light bulb, because Mostly they didn't use them by then. It looked like it was taken to incandescence. But they are all broken. And I can't find the buttons, or maybe they were automatic. The air conditioning units, which are also not working. Rather not very architecturally inspiring houses. Oh, my camera's off focus. So annoying when that happens, but okay, I've refocused my camera to the church. That sign says we're going to double track, it's an arrow symbol. When Top Gear went on the Great Central Railway, it wasn't this section, it was... Well, because there are, as far as I know, three open sections. There's London, Marylebone to Aylesbury Vale Parkway, Leicester North to Loughborough Central, and this section, which is just north of Loughborough. To Ruddington Park, Ruddington. When Top Gear went on the Great Central Railway. Oh, we're driving on the right now. Look, we're not going on the left, we're driving on the right. When Top Gear went on the Great Central Railway, they actually drove on the right, like we're doing now. If none of you noticed, when Top Gear went on the Great Central Railway, they drove on the right. And we're driving on the right now, I guess it was a bit fitting, although it does mean that the main entrance to the station, which, I mean, this is a pretty poor excuse for a station, but nevertheless, the main entrance to the station, which is that ramp there, is now on the other platform to the one we're stopping on. It still says that the next train is for Loughborough, even though we've been and come back. We're now a northbound train. Last trip halt. And that sign looks like it's made of some sort of fiberglass. This is a pretty poor excuse for a station. I mean, you don't have very much here. It also looks rather cheap. Doesn't look really very good, it looks rather cheap. This door is rather good quality. That's the train going over the point. I don't understand why it makes that sound. I mean, it's like the train's gone over detonators, but the train has not gone over detonators, it's gone over points. So I don't know. Right, something like that. And these sleepers are a bit decayed. They've got a few holes. Many places where all the bitumen's come off. But some of them still have quite a bit of their preservative bitumen on. It has three carriages. Yet, oddly enough, it has three toilets. However, two of them are out of order, only one of them works. Down there is where we came from. It's the single track main line. There's only the down track, no up track. And we're now on the down track because it's the reversing siding. And this is the footbridge I showed you earlier, and up there the line continues until it eventually reaches the tram stop. I'd rather like them to extend it and have an interchange with the trams. And now we're turning off the main line to go back into Ruddington Park Depot. Cutting, so you'd hardly believe that there's even a railway there. And there's a level crossing. These steam trains always seem to feel rather awkward. They go rather slowly and they don't make a satisfying motor noise. They just make these squeaks and rattles and bangs. So you never really feel that much. You never really feel like you've left the station. Yeah. You never really feel like you've left the area immediately outside the station, it feels like. So we're back in Ruddington Park Depot. Going very slowly. Then I went in the locomotive cab.
Or Polish, isn't it? Well, it's so black. Yeah. It's not Welsh, that's for sure.
Oh, well, you know about coal, don't you? Well, it's all black, isn't it? It's good, isn't it?
Wow.
It's
half
you get to drive this, take it in turns, do you?
So, over there is Bedford Midland Station's platform Ha. And there you have some class 700s. I want to go on a class 700. I don't even know for sure if they're running yet. That track there is a track from the train wash. We should go over Bedford St. John's pretty soon. this facility is massive. There's some electrified tracks over there. I couldn't even see what bridge they crossed the river on. Hang on. We're on the local tracks. That's odd. Why are we on the local tracks? Sure, we've already passed Bedford St. John's going at this speed for this long. Just didn't see it. Oh, actually, we just passed it just now. And that is a park and ride. I like park and rides. That's not the nicest park and ride I've ever seen, though.